only I could actually see what the
Wait, was it in the color voice?
Okay, here's an important question. Do you have your screen set up?
Okay, how is this? Because now I have. Can you hear me now? Hello, is this audible? Okay, nice. But like, can you. Okay, Ruts can't try to speak something, yeah. Because. No, I mean, Ratskant, you should speak something because I want to see if Les is able to hear you. Like livestream.com/chocolatehammer. I think everything is fine except I'm hearing my voice echoed back to me about half a second later. So I mean, I guess if this is fine, then we'll continue and. After 2 hours, I'll just go crazy or something. Yeah. Maybe now. Like I had this headphone monitor option enabled, but now I've turned it off and I have stopped hearing the echo. So maybe this is what was the missing link. Yeah, I need somebody to verify if like you guys are like if all three of us are audible on this live stream thingy, so we can actually like start this thing. Okay, can you hear me? Like this is me speaking right now, and I think the weather is pretty nice. Interesting. So I have speakers audio set up. I have the microphone set up. What's not? Like as soon as I like, should I click this headphone monitor and like, or should I remove my headphones? Like what's the deal? This is really very weird. Can I actually see the comments? Like, is this live stream tool able to do that? I'm not seeing any widgets. Maybe this audio mixer thing is obscuring that. Okay, so I guess like, what about, like, should you guys just like pretend to be my imaginary friends or something? Like, what? Okay. All right, so yeah, what's, yeah, so like are we live? Are people actually watching this, the whole mess of a thing we have got here? Oh, wow. Okay, that's pretty cool. Yeah. So, hey all, what's up? Yeah, this is pretty shambolic at the moment, to say the least. So I'm actually looking for the comments. I can't, what the hell? I thought live stream was, oh wait, here it is. Too bad I can't actually see anything, like, in the comments. Facebook, Twitter, live stream. Like, oh wait, now it's loading. Yeah, wait a minute. Yeah, now it's loading. It's actually, so yeah, I guess I'll just remove this this push to talk key because my finger is starting to hurt. Yeah, so yeah, can you guys still hear me, like, on the stream? No replies. Maybe they cannot hear me. Yeah, that's great. Okay, so yeah, so how we are going to do this is, so how we are going to do this is that Ratskan and Liz are going to speak in my ears. Yeah, I don't know, like, how the hell to get Ratskan on this, because it's I'm going to try this mixer thing once more. Yeah, okay, so now Ratskan, can you speak for a, so what, so yeah, if you guys have any, yeah, that's what we are going to do, I guess, because it's yeah, I guess I should have, like, yeah, I usually have trouble with this live stream tool anyway. So, like, guys, hey, what's up? Like, if you have any questions and such, now is the time. I think, yeah, hey, Les, like, you had those, I wonder if you have that recorded footage or, like, screenshots of the progress we have made. That might come in handy. Yeah. Why does love have to be so sad? Yeah, I guess, I don't know, like I mean if I were capable to love, I would probably, like, be able to answer your question much better, but yeah, that's, yeah, you should probably ask this to somebody more qualified, like, I don't know, that's gone, like, yeah. No, I mean, the first question we have is, why does love got to be so sad? I mean, I don't know, like, I mean, if I were capable of loving somebody, I would probably know better. But yeah. Like, you might actually be closer to the truth, publicly, secret. Yeah. Yeah, because, yeah, actually, yeah, part of the, writing is pretty much, like, I guess, like, 70-30, so I guess Ratskan is maybe a voice in my head, and I just, like, you know, when I sleep, I just sleepwalk and I start typing, and then, wait, Ratskan is actually, like, answering this seriously. Like, I'm not sure if that's in the spirit of this live stream, because right. So yeah, so let me just do a little progress recap for you, the reason we are here. So in the past month, like, it has been almost exactly a month and a week since we were funded by Kickstarter. In that time, we have entirely revamped the script for chapter 1. We have the side quest, a majority of the side quest dialogue and the main quest dialogue ready. And yeah, at this point, Mick is just back from vacation. He was away for like 4 or 5 days. And now he's going to do the internal tile sets. Once he has finished that, he's going to draw those items and stuff, and then work on the city itself. So that's where the progress is on the. Oh, that's cool. Oh, yeah. So my imaginary friend, i.e. Ratskan, told me that the update is almost up. So yeah. So I guess a few more people will join us then. And yeah, I guess till Les is viewing those screenshots. What else have we got? Yeah, programming wise, I actually finished programming collisions between n-sided polygons, which is awesome because it's like kind of complex, and like I was able to do it in 2 days. So yeah. Wait, my thumbs are not visible. Okay, now they are visible. Yeah, so you know. What else? What else did we actually do? Oh yeah, the music is almost finished. Yeah, you'll be listening, you'll hear from us then, I guess. Yeah. So what else is there? Let's see. Yeah, I mean, exactly, you know, I mean, if you are not able to like do stuff like, you know, basic collision detection and like how are you, like if you're painting something, you need to know when your paintbrush is colliding with the, you know, whatever stuff you're drawing, you know, like the Mona Lisa or whatever. So I mean, you know, that's pretty essential. And like doing programming updates is pretty weird, because I'm like, okay, how do I simplify this so non-programmers can listen? But then it kind of removes the charm, you know, almost, because it's like I cannot talk about how I went implementing this algorithm, what did I do, you know. So yeah, I guess, yeah, this just kind of makes me sad. Yeah, I haven't actually, like, yeah, because I guess, yeah, I mean, I guess I'm not like, what do you call, what's the word, Christian. Yeah, I'm not Christian, so I don't actually know the creation of Adam or whatever. So yeah, I guess like, I don't know, like a guy was created from something, Adam, and then like he collided with some, I don't know what the hell. Oh, I see. So actually, yeah. Yeah, so Ratskan has just told me so Ratskan and Liz have just told me what this creation of Adam thing is. Like, I actually prefer Rocketeer's version. Like, it's, yeah, it's a lot. Yeah. Yeah. So I mean, I don't know. Like, I guess it's cool. Like, I mean, you know, dudes painting stuff, you know, I guess that's cool. So, well, publicly secret is actually a programmer. Yeah, programmer bro fest. Like, I hope you were ready for that, you know, like, and you like touched your fist on this, like, you know. Yeah, because yeah, so yeah, so, yeah, like how can I know how many people have showed up, because I Rocketeer is kind of a programmer, like, yeah, that's almost programming, right? I mean, it's like hard-coded programming, I guess. Yeah, you should just like post those in like the comments, you know, like link them in like the public folder of your Dropbox, and yeah, that's probably better. Yeah. Oh right, so like in Mass Effect. Okay, so I'm supposed to. Okay, so whenever Ratskarn or Les is talking, I'm supposed to. Yeah, so I'm supposed to do it like this. Okay, yeah, okay. So I guess like when it's my left hand, it's Ratskarn, and when it's my right hand, it's Les. So that way you can, you guys can easily like see what version is what. So and when I'm like this, I mean like, hey, you guys shut the hell up. I'm talking to people, okay? Oh, hey, Ryan. Yeah. Hey, Ryan, what's up? Yeah, so it looks like actually that Ryan is our like most loyal follower because nobody else is actually showing up, you know, like. Well, I mean, I guess right for Ruts and left for Liz would be okay, but like, you know, that's what the man says, you know, like, yeah, we are like indie rebels and stuff. Wait, what? Wait, I think. Oh, wait a minute. This is the. Oh, wrong here. So, like, Les is saying something about a map. Wait, what happened to the map? Right. So, I guess, yeah. Hang on a minute. I'll actually check what Les is saying. Okay, so apparently there is a map issue. Like, should I just take the screenshot and upload it? Because like I can see the map all fine. Like, I'm not sure what you are saying by the map issue. Like, apparently for our viewers, it's apparently a bug in the map. I'm not sure. I'll probably just take the screenshot myself and just. Okay, so I'm checking the map right now. Yeah, I mean I can see the map all right, you know, and like the objective markers on it and such. I'm not sure what you mean by the bug. Like I'm going to upload. Like, can I actually share my screen with you guys at the moment? Yeah, there you go. So like, can you see this? Like the people in the comments, can you see this? It's like I cannot actually see the comments. Okay, so yeah, you guys can see the comments, right? But then I cannot see the comments, so I'm going to yeah, okay, this is way better. Yeah. Okay, so this is what our map is. So you can just sort of, you know, drag and drop it, you know. Yeah, exactly. So yeah. So yeah, that is actually because the top left, this x is because we haven't initialized it yet. So it's on 0 comma 0, like, you know, like all sensible stuff is. And this is where we are at right now. This is where we need to be. And since we haven't initialized where we need to be, that's 0 comma 0. So that's our map gone. And now I'm like roaming through this. Like, pardon me for the low frame rate, but it's probably because I'm live streaming stuff and I have like 50 screens open at the same time. I think it's probably because of that. Yeah, so yeah, I'll actually like try to steer clear because you guys are not supposed to know their names yet. It's all. Yeah, but this is
It's really amusing to see the spy doing his butt scoot backwards and forwards.
Yeah, that is actually
Yeah,
a
spy
bug. Yeah,
needs
that's
fixing on that,
actually
honestly.
like
It's
his.
because like
Oh
Talbot's
god damn, I just heard
framed.
myself really loud on the stream. That's happening now? That's working?
Yeah.
Oh, is the stream working?
Yeah, I have the
Yeah.
stream audio on, and suddenly I boomed in twice as loud as I
Butt
am.
scoot!
Oh.
Okay, I'm not gonna have this opportunity probably later, since it's probably gonna stop working as soon as he goes back to camera, so. Any song requests? Anyone?
Wait, like, can you guys actually hear Ratskarn? So, like, he's real, like now
Speed
you guys
call!
know,
Do
like,
it!
I'm not lying. Song break. Okay, so this is me actually. Yeah, this is our peasant army that you see right here. There's this floating lady, and there's this lady who is an imaginary.
You are lucky that.
Oh wait a minute! I just walked on a house. Yeah, that collisions will be fixed. Okay, we have like see this. So we haven't actually initialized the collisions yet. So, but you can see all this awesome data that's coming in, right? It's like, oh yeah, that kind of thing. Let's can't please don't actually sing, you know. Yeah. So yeah, that's where we are at right now. It's like a level, and it's like all this debug awesome stuff, you know. Yeah, so I mean, when I press semicolon, this stuff happens. No, not semicolon, it's called tilde, I think. Yeah, that's what it is, like, tilde or whatever. Yeah. So yeah, so I hope people are wait, we have about 13 people. Yeah, so this is the awesome pause menu. Like, it's a pretty revolutionary feature we have added, where it's like you can press this and then suddenly the game, like the entire time stops in this universe. I think it's pretty awesome, you know. Like, I mean, we actually went into the physics code and we like stopped time completely. So yeah, you know. And then this is the save menu. Like, this is also like stuff will be filled in this area soon. And this is like the options menu. You know, the settings menu. This is the codex and like the journal. So yeah, mechanically we are pretty close. Like, right now the major obstacle would be filling in actual content. Like, I'm sure Ratskan has a bit more to say about like the writing process and such. So if you wanna take it away, Ratskan, yeah.
Okay, so for the writing process, I'm actually going to go ahead and mute the stream because I'm going to be able to hear myself otherwise, and that's always really discouraging when I can hear the things that comes out of my mouth. Moving on. So as far as the writing process goes, it's been pretty iterative. We did like a few drafts of the script. I just turned around a new draft of the third draft of this iteration of the main chapter, and the second draft of the side quests. But one thing that's very interesting is that once the dialogue actually goes into the game out of the notepad file that we compile it in, it's actually, when you're going through it, you suddenly realize just how what you wrote isn't perfectly suited to the video game format. Like, it's hard to explain, but like, when you write it down in notepad, like you're writing it like a book or something, all the dialogue seems very reasonable. It seems like a thing a character would say. But then it comes up into the three dialogue options, and you realize that it doesn't have the format of dialogue in a video game. It doesn't have the RPG dialogue conventions. And I'm actually still kind of nailing down exactly what those are and what it is that makes a sentence seem weird to be like a 1-2-3 response option. And what makes, but you know, it would be natural NPC dialogue. It's just, it wouldn't feel natural. You wouldn't feel natural choosing it as something that you would say. I think pessimistically, you could say that there's a bit of blandness that needs to be there because the player needs to be able to read it in their own voice. But I think it's really more just that you need to have the character's voice, but in a way that's can be interpreted ambiguously a little bit, so that the player can spackle in the holes. Anyway, that's apparently pretty aggressively irritating to listen to on the stream. So instead of breaking out into my planned rap number, I'll just go ahead and settle down.
Yeah, so what you guys are actually seeing right now is the you'll have like people who are hilariously inept at rapping trying to rap later, but let's like what you're seeing right now actually
get back. What did I miss?
Yeah, Okay, oh, so they are, so yeah, that's what I'm actually coming to, like what the colors on the top. These represent the three types of opinion people have about you. This, the green opinion is the friendship opinion, which is like, yeah. Yeah, they are friendship, respect, and fear bars. So, yeah. Yeah, so I mean, the order does not really matter as much as the content of these bars, as in, these bars are what represent the character's opinions towards you. So like, if the friendship bar is high, but the respect and fear bars are low, this means you're good friends, but if you try to compel somebody, like, you know, appeal to their morals, if you try to ask them to do something, they'll probably not do it, because they'll be like, oh yeah, you're my good friend, but yeah, like, I don't think like this, you know. So in a way, respect is, so yeah, friendship is how much they like you, respect is how much they like your moral stance, you know, like not act like the, like not a hard-coded moral stance, but more like how much they agree with your ideals and your methods and that kind of thing. And fear is how much you can actually intimidate them, because right now you are just a peasant girl, so that's why you, everyone you'll meet will probably have a low value of fear, because ultimately you're just a, like, you know, 14-15 year old peasant girl, so you'll probably not be able to intimidate people easily, especially, you know, like guards and stuff like that. But like later on you'll play different characters, and some of them will be able to use their intimidation skills much more, much better. So what this chapter is about is mostly, I'm just going to skip this stuff for now, because I don't want you guys to, yeah, that's kind of where we are, where the different characters are much more than the
Arvind, I probably wouldn't interrupt you here. I have to mute it so I can talk, and I also come in at a seemingly random point in the actual stream's length. But I do have one point to make, which is I was playing through the build of the game, and I actually think it would be interesting if, when we have those bars, if changes are made sort of persistent, like there's a ghost of what happened. That didn't make a whole lot of sense. What I mean is, like, currently what we have it is that when you click one, there's a flash and it sort of changes in a direction. It might work better if there was sort of like an after image that persists for throughout that dialogue option, lets you see at your leisure what change was made.
Oh, right. So I know what you mean. Right. So you can see, like, here's what their stats were before, and here's what their stats are the after, or...
Yeah. Like, could
you... like, at the end of the conversation, and see how much has changed in their opinion of you.
Like, I'm not sure if you...
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, I mean...
That's pretty cool idea.
Also, man, I caught the end of what I said, and I sound evil as hell.
Yeah, so yeah, that's...
I'm sure Marvin is even here.
No, I'm here, right? I mean, I was drinking water, actually. So yeah, I mean, that yeah, like, that sounds pretty useful. And, like, it's not really that hard to implement. So, I mean, I can do that. Yeah. You know, I'm on the house, if you guys can see this. So... yeah, so... So yeah, I mean, yeah, we can do that. So yeah, that's where like there's also the inventory, but we don't actually have any items displayed right now. But like later, you'll get like once the game is more polished, you'll get items. They'll modify a certain character's dialogue. You'll get more like you know, information about the lore and such. And like, yeah, this is where the quests. Oh, I think I removed that bogus quests option, but yeah that's pretty much where we are at right now in terms of the build. So yeah, so if you guys have any questions about any particular area, like, I've given you the general overview of where we are at, but if you have any particular questions about a part of the process, or like for me, Ratskan, or Ian in particular, that, like, now would be a good time to I wonder what this button does.
Well, obviously, the first question we've got is the scooching intentional?
No, I'll tell you what the scooching is caused by. The scooching is caused by the sprite strip from that particular character being 2 or 3 pixels off to the right in 3 of his frames. So, for the first 2 or 3 frames, it's fine, and then it goes scoot, 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 and I'm like, this is going to be a pain to change. And I could fix that right now by changing how each box on the frame is aligned in the XML, but it would be incredibly fiddly, and it would just be easier to fix the sprite itself. So right now he's going to scoot for a little while longer.
Yeah. So we are actually in the, I would say, alpha.
I need a link to stream so I can see questions.
Phase, right? mechanic. Yeah, we are like the main thing that's left is the content, not the actual code or the mechanics. Those are pretty close to final.
Okay,
so yeah, I guess, I'd say we are in the alpha phase right now, where more content has to be added and stuff like that.
So the scooting is a bug, and it will be fixed.
Yeah. I guess I should probably roam around a bit, like show you guys some more of the levels. How with like we are at, my laptop is like at, this is like, I don't know what, it's like 20 or 15 frames, yeah, it's like 16 frames per second, oh my god. Priya, great dance. Okay, so what do you guys, so this is another level, and you guys, I can actually see one of the pre-art overhaul scripts, sprites in this level. So we have a couple of questions. Bug or pre-alpha breakdancing skits? Yeah, so it's probably a bug. And are you guys happy with your pipeline for art slash other content? I know how much a pain in the star that can be. So, yeah, we are pretty happy. Like, yeah, it's more of a case of like the time it takes to get from like use that pipeline to actually, you know, create content, because it's going to be a bunch of sprites. It's going to be a bunch of levels. So right now we are in the process of drawing those. So those will take some time, and like. Then they'll take some more time to actually polish and stuff like that. So we're pretty happy with our pipeline. Like, yeah, I mean, it's pretty easy to use for all of us. Like, Mick pretty much just has to use Photoshop. Ratskan and Ian pretty much just have to use Notepad. I mean, I just pretty much have to use Visual C++. Yeah, I mean, you can just import normal PNG images into the game. Like, it's not a... Like, we don't use any of the, like, you know, custom formats and such. Yeah, actually, this also makes it pretty easy to mod, because all you have to do to like add a new level or add a new sprite is to just open up a sprite file and, you know, just modify bits of it with Paint or Photoshop or whatever. So the question is there a plan to have NPCs move around, or is it just the PC that's going to be moving in most situations? So I'd say in most situations, the PC is going to move, the NPCs are going to stay still, but in certain events and in certain areas, the NPCs will also move about. Backer says the walking speed looks pretty slow. Oh yeah, that's because of the, like, my laptop can't actually handle the live stream and this simultaneously. So if you see on the top right, we are actually running at about 18 frames per second. So the actual game will run at 60 frames per second, and the walking speed will be way fast. So like, it's actually because my laptop cannot handle the whole, you know, streaming plus the game running and plus like Visual Studio running and Firefox and stuff like that, you know. Like, it's a laptop, you know, like about 3 years old now. So, yeah, I mean, obviously, yeah. I mean, we probably won't, do a Kickstarter for specific hardware. I mean, yeah, but yeah, Yeah, I mean, walk speed can pretty much be tweaked easily. It's like just a little number in a text file, you know? So, but like, I'd like your opinions on whether like you guys think that this art looks cool, or you know, like do you think this art looks cool? Like, should we improve certain areas of this, stuff like that? Because yeah, I'm particularly proud of the levels. Sprites would need some tweaking. Like for now, there is no bottom, bottom walking animation kind of thing where it's facing downwards. But yeah, but I'm pretty happy with the backgrounds. Like you can see this pretty nice stall and such. There's going to be a merchant here soon. So yeah, I'm interested in hearing your opinions on what this like on the art and like. Do you think this is pretty and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Okay, that's pretty cool. So yeah, I mean, yeah, what we'll probably end up doing is that every time we show you new gameplay footage, we'll probably just show Yeah, we'll probably just end up showing this set of levels rather than like show the actual city and stuff. Like, I mean, we'll show you some screenshots, but we'll just show this area in motion. So what I think we'll do end up doing is just make this chapter one like, you know, complete visual spoiler territory, you know, as in we'll like roam around these areas, like tell you the like, okay, this is how it's going to work out, you know, like an actual game. So that way what will happen is that we can actually package this chapter as a demo of the actual game and not be like, okay, is it going to be story spoilers, is it going to be this? Yeah, that I think that would end up, because like we don't want to show you too much, but at the same time we also want to be a bit open about the process, you know, and like not keep you guys completely in the dark about, okay, this is how the game is going to play and that kind of thing. So I think this is probably the best approach to go in terms of the whole, you know, the like development process sharing and stuff like that. Yeah, actually, Stice says maybe some subtle black lines or something to increase contrast would be good. Seems a bit too much on the vague side. Yeah, I mean, actually, this is pretty like high resolution. Like, yeah, we will probably end up refining this just a little bit more. Like, this well is all like, you know, this is work in progress, this well stuff. Yeah, I mean, in the end, that's kind of why the sprites are actually way more, you know, like, they are way more saturated in color. Yeah, that is King of Dragon Pass. Yeah, I'm like, I haven't played it. Yeah, like all that much, but yeah, I'm liking what I played so far. Like, it's pretty unique, and to think of it that it was made in like almost like a decade ago, maybe more, and that's really impressive for me. So yeah, while we are on our slow walk through the countryside, so do you guys have anything else to ask me? Like, okay, so Stice asks, you have a pretty international team. Is everybody living in Jaipur now? No, I mean, actually, I am the only person living in Jaipur. Ratskan is like, I think, in the middle of nowhere, America. And Les is in UK somewhere, I guess. I don't know, Leeds or Scotland. I don't know where the hell Les is. But he's somewhere in England or the UK or whatever, you know. The area ruled by the Queen, you know, that he's in that place. And Ratskan is in middle of nowhere / America. Yeah, so and Mick is in Estonia. I'm not sure where in Estonia he is, but yeah, he's somewhere in Estonia. And like, I am in,
remember, yeah, kids,
geography.
Yeah, so yeah, Will there be hotspots indicator where you can click on? Yeah, actually.
I was about to do a break.
Yeah,
when I broke in with Remember Kids there, I was about to do a breakdown of the United Kingdom, but I realized that was completely not relevant to what was going on, and I probably just interrupted again. This audio is butts.
Yeah. Yes, I mean, if you can see this small icon and her name on top here. So then you can see that, okay, this is an interactive object. So this sort of thing will be there for all interactive objects. Oh, right. So I guess now you guys can hear me in mumble. By you guys, I mean Les and Ratskan. Mercindy asks us questions regarding the backer rewards. When will you send emails out to the reward tiers that need to give information to get famous people in the lore based on them or design a guild or so forth? Mercindy, I'd say in about a month or a couple of months. So like, yeah. So I mean, if you want to, if you have certain ideas, you can start working like sketching them out, or you can just email me. You know, like if you go to pyrodactyl.com. There's this email icon right at the top, which has my email address. So you can email me that, okay, hey, I'm your backer, I'd like this, and I'll like file it in my, I'll obviously send the official backer email later once we are ready to actually start importing those stuff. But yeah, for purely text-based stuff and like text and logo, which is like the guild and stuff, we'll send those out earlier than the rest. For the sprites, we'll actually wait till we are till we have the whole game fleshed out, so we know, okay, like we can fit in a sprite at this time and we can fit in a sprite over here, you know. Yeah, so we'll wait for the sprite and the visual backers, like the landmarks and such. We'll wait for those a little while longer, but yeah, text wise we can do pretty much I'd say expect it around like a month or a couple of months from now. What else did I miss anything? Let me see. No, I think okay. So yeah, oh yeah, one question was that will there be items to interact with? Yeah, there will be collectible items and you can interact with items, and those items will tell you a little bit about the lore. They might modify some characters, dialogues, you know, that kind of thing. So yeah, that stuff will be there. So guys, like, what to fund as part of kicking it forward? Well, I've already bagged Undertale. Like, yeah, it's like the profits from our project, but I've already bagged Undertale, which is a great thing. It's like a, yeah, Undertale is awesome. And then, I don't want to like start backing stuff right now, because I mean, obviously, you know, like, backing stuff with the profits of, because like for one we don't actually have profits yet, and you know, yeah, Undertale's Kickstarter is actually over, I think. So yeah, but you can check it out, see, like, there's a demo, it's a pretty nice, yeah, but we do plan to kick it forward, or like, yeah, I mean, at the very least support some interesting projects and such, you know.
Yeah, I'm not going to be talking about Undertale too much because I really, really do like it.
Okay. Oh yeah, I just actually, yeah, and it was like, oh, infinite means. Yeah, that was, I might actually have a use for infinite urns. I mean, that, like, I would get some of those lazy fucks to actually help me out in programming, you know, like. But okay, yeah. So like, do you guys have any other questions and such?
Infinite Arvins is somebody.
Yeah, he
areas are the next on Mick's to-do list. That's some of these sprites which are actually standing out here in the open right now will be indoors. So yeah, that's next on our to-do list, indoor levels. So I mean, soon you will be able to walk inside each of these huts and, you know, see the inside of them, that kind of thing. So yeah, that's definitely on the cards. Which actually reminds me, Ratskan, you need to make a list for Mick about what indoor levels we need exactly, you know? Yeah, Mick was telling me this.
Indoor areas, right, gotcha.
Yeah. Day-night cycles and weather effects, not exactly. I mean, I guess subtle ones, but we won't have dynamic day-night effects because that kind of completely messes our schedule and budget stuff up. So yeah, we won't have completely dynamic day-night cycles, but we'll have little effects here and there. This might actually be a credits level now, you know, infinite urban level. But yeah, I won't.
Don't get my test, people.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, because in 3D you can sort of do this with, program stuff and stuff. But in 2D it needs to be kind of drawn, or you need to do some really tricky sort of visual tricks to have, yeah. Yeah, I mean, obviously, because time scale wise, the game is not time matters, because the whole game will take place in about 2 or 3 days, but it won't be real time, as in there won't be a 48 hour counter to your actions. But yeah, I mean, yeah, actually that will happen. Some chapters will take place in the night, some will take place in noon, some will take place in evening, because the entire duration of the game as such, in if somebody were writing a history book for the events of this game, the events in this game would take place over a period of 2 or 3 days. So yeah, in that sense we will have stuff if one chapter is in broad daylight, the other is at the night, and then the third is in the evening, that kind of thing. So yeah, we do have plans for that, but yeah, it won't be dynamic, as in if you just stand there, it won't be the sun is setting and then the moon shows up. Yeah, it won't be like that. But there will be night levels and there will be day levels. I mean, at least that's what we are planning for. I mean, I won't guarantee that. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I mean, I cannot. How linear / non-linear are you planning to make the game? Pretty non-linear. I mean, I won't say it's completely non-linear, every action you can, I don't want to go full Peter Molyneux on you guys. But it's pretty branching, there are a lot of branches. There's at least 3 endings for each chapter, at least 3 different endings for each chapter. So Marzendi asks, I don't know if it's too spoilery, but across these 2 or 3 days, will there be overlap between chapters? I only ask as we're discussing time anyway. There might be slight overlap, but probably not. They are sequential for the most part, but there might be slight overlap, which I don't want to spoil too much for you. But yeah, mostly they are sequential, because that sort of helps us in the whole cause and effect kind of thing, where we can, you know. But yeah, some segments might overlap. Yeah, that's all I can say without spoiling too much. So less than that, can't gone silent. I'm not sure if they're still here.
No, we're still here.
I'm not entirely confident in how my audio is coming through, so I'm holding off on commenting.
Yeah, I was really booming in the stream, so.
Yeah. Okay. So I guess you can just Okay. So any other questions? I need to work on this. I'm saying okay so too many times. Yeah, these guys are too loud. Yeah, they talk too much, don't they? They just shut up and start working. Actually, yeah. What the hell?
FIFA.
I fall for
Are you welcome?
Do we have anything else?
I was actually thinking of doing this for like 1.5 hours or so we can like we could have room for enough questions, and we have shown people pretty much like most of the game stuff, I think. I guess we can like hang around for like 15 minutes, see if like people like have any other questions. Otherwise we'll just wrap this up then. So yeah, so if you want, so if you have any questions, now is the time for now is the time for asking them. Okay, silence in the chat so far. You're welcome. Yeah, well, we are here for about let's say 15 more minutes, right? So that will push the stream into like 1 hour 10 minute territory, which is pretty much what we are shooting for. So yeah, so if you guys like, so yeah, this, yeah, we can just like shoot the breeze, you know, like, so yeah, like, yeah, talk about some other stuff. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's Diavaris says, am I spelling it right? Okay, whatever. It's hard to ask questions when everything looks good. Oh, yeah, that's the best. Yeah. It's kind of weird, like, because I don't have the orientation of where my like face and like hands are with respect to the webcam. So it's kind of weird, because like I try to be like, you know, so it's kind of weird. But yeah, but I get it right eventually, you know. I wonder why so. I guess it's sort of the thing to do with time zones. I guess it's not convenient for everyone. Plus, probably like live stream is pretty much a live kind of event, right? So I mean, if you miss the email and you check it an hour back, yeah. So I mean, that then you have just missed the live stream. So I guess it's kind of like that. Yeah, I mean, we this is an area where I welcome feedback, because what we tried to do was, we tried to have an update a week ago about saying that, okay, yeah, we'll have a live stream this at this time. And then we did an update immediately, where it was like, okay, live stream is live now, join in. So yeah, so that's what we tried to do. I mean, we don't want to make it like, you know, if every 24 hours we email you saying, oh, hey, live stream, you know. That is like a sort of asking for people to like unsubscribe or whatever. yeah, because a lot of the feedback I actually got from people on Kickstarter was that we have too many projects that we have backed, so please don't spam our inboxes with like frivolous stuff. So I was like, okay, yeah, we'll try to keep it at a minimum. So I think, yeah, two updates for this is fine. If we make this a habit, I think a lot more people will like show up, because like, since this is the first stream, like getting people to know is the more hard, like it's the more difficult kind of thing. But yeah, if we keep doing this periodically, then people will start showing up eventually, I think. So yeah, okay, random stuff I want to talk to you guys about. One, I need buddies to play Monaco with. So like, I know Ratskan has Monaco. I'm not sure if Les has it.
I actually do not have Monaco.
Oh, you don't?
I do not.
I saw the Monaco live stream on Chocolate Hammer a while ago.
So oh no, I'm gonna have to do
that. I was just bitching at people, distracting them so they couldn't formulate any actual strategies.
Oh, right. So yeah, so I mean, backers, like if you want to play Monaco with me, like now is a great time, like, yeah, because I need buddies to play Monaco with. So like, just send me an email, like, and I'll add you on Steam, you know, yeah, and we can play Monaco, you know, like steal stuff and like that, you know. And another thing, I guess, like, can we talk about like, have you guys Yeah, awesome. So, like, can you, like, have you guys seen any movies lately? I mean, I don't know what to talk about. So, I mean, like, I've seen, like, Man of Steel and Pacific Rim. Not sure if you guys have seen this.
No, I've not seen Man of Steel, Pacific Rim, and I don't want to see Man of Steel because that looks like a terrible Superman movie, and I am not impressed.
Yeah.
I will be seeing Pacific Rim in the near future.
I mean, is it still in theaters? Because it's off theaters in India now. Like, yeah.
I think it's still in theaters, yeah, absolutely. They keep theaters as long as they can bleed anybody for a ticket over here.
I mean, I guess, like, in India, it's kind of the opposite because, I mean, they'll only keep films in theaters until people are actually visiting the theaters because Bollywood has, like, so many movies come out every week. It's, like, 3 new movies every week. So, I mean, every time you are keeping a movie that's not selling tickets, that's basically loss for you. So foreign movies are pretty much like 1 week shows, that's it. So yeah, so I had to see both Man of Steel and Pacific Rim in within the weekend they released because otherwise it would be like... Yeah, I mean, Pacific Rim is pretty cool. Like if as long as you're not expecting high art, I mean, like don't expect it to subvert any of the like, you know, typical anime mecha conventions and such. But it is pretty exciting in a way because like this type of thing, like you would not have expected to be made. Yeah. Like about even like 5 years ago or like 10 years ago. And I mean, it's a pretty like one of those movies where like you know that the director is also as excited to make this movie as the fans, because like a couple of times the characters are like, oh yeah, this is pretty cool. So yeah, I mean that I thought that was a nice shout out to. Like, I think it's Del Toro, right? Yeah, I mean, he's made some pretty good movies in the past. I mean, yeah, I mean, as long as you don't expect high art, Pacific Rim is pretty awesome. And, like, yeah, Man of Steel, like, action was pretty good. Like, I mean, it was pretty much live-action Dragon Ball Z done in, like... Yeah, yeah, Rocketeer is actually pretty spot-on. Like, he says, there's something to be said for throwing as much money and care as you can gather into what would have been a B-movie. James Cameron made his whole career on that formula, yeah. Pretty much, yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah, I mean, like for Man of Steel, what it was basically the fight scenes were live action Dragon Ball Z with a $200 million budget. I mean, it was just crazy. Like for the first half, I was like, what the hell is this? This movie is too preachy. It's like, and like it. Like it pays lip service to the idea of Superman being like a sort of hope for all mankind, but doesn't actually do anything like anything with it. But like, but when the action starts, it's just so like it doesn't allow you to catch a breath. Like at least 3 times I was like, okay, this has to be the final set piece of the movie. But no, the movie went on and like, yeah, I mean, and the destruction was just immense. Like. It's basically if somebody was like, okay, yeah, we need to copy Dragon Ball Z, guys, okay, yeah, that's what, yeah. So, I mean, I'd say watch it just for the, like, action alone. Again, I mean, if you walk into the second half, you won't have missed anything, like, story-wise. Because it's, like, the first half is typical Superman stuff, which you know already, you know. But, yeah, the action is pretty good, I'd say. So, I'd still go and watch it. Like at least once, just for the action scenes. So that's the movie stuff out of the way.
So that's the Pyrodactyl movie review section of it.
Yeah, we should do this more often, actually.
The sad part is we have more viewers now than we did when we started.
Sorry, everyone who came to talk about unrest. We were talking about Superman.
Yeah. I mean, okay, so for the new viewers, I'll just quickly march through this collection of sprites we have and then, you know, dum-dum-dum-dum. So yeah, this is all pretty rough work in progress. This is the map screen, you guys, you know, map screen. Then this is the pause menu with the revolutionary stop time feature. And then this is the character screen. It's empty, but it will be like filled, like as when we actually like add abilities and icons and descriptions for them. Then this is the journal. Yeah, right now it's pretty empty because, like, as I said, yeah, I mean, you know, it's still work in progress. And like the inventory, which is also empty, but it will come in soon. So yeah, mechanically, I'd say we are close to set. But yeah, we'll have more full, you know, like full blown stuff for you as we do these streams further along. And yeah, Rocket. Yeah, if you have ordered the physical tiers, you will get this map and the two concept images. So if you want like those, then yeah, I mean, yeah, I think you can just pretty much contact me and I'll set you up. Like if you want to, if you've already ordered, then great, you'll get those. And like if you want this, like this map and like posters and such. Yeah. Oh, right. Another thing, actually, which me and Ratskan and Liz actually talked about, but I completely forgot until now. So yeah. So we in the end, it turned out only 12 backers. Only the pledges of 12 backers did not come through, and in one of those pledges, there was the option of the legend tier. So what? So as a sort of exclusive tidbit for you live stream guys, what we are going to do is we are going to hold up a contest where we are going to you have to name and write a couple of lines of description about an NPC, and we'll pick the one that's most interesting and we'll put that person in the game. So yeah. So yeah, I mean that usually happens. I mean, it's some like credit card stuff happens and like, so yeah, so that's what we'll have a contest. So you guys can like write a small a name of a character. Like we'd prefer if it were like, you know, Indian stuff, because we don't want like, you know, Awesome Pants Muggy. No, I mean not right now. We have time. Like I'm going to say until the next live stream. So that's a month. We'll also do a text update for this in case you need a reminder. I mean, obviously, if you like give us something awesome right now, then I mean you'll have won, you know, like. Yeah. So yeah. So if you can name an NPC and write a couple of lines about that. I mean, yeah, that's. Yeah. So I mean, if you can. So ideally, you should be able. Like, it should have an Indian name, and we don't want like, you know, like name like Awesome Pants McGee, which is like a great name, but like it's not an Indian name, you know. So I mean, yeah. So it should fit with the setting. And I mean, it shouldn't be too like Mary Sue like, you know, I mean, like we don't want characters like, okay, he has a jetpack and he has a big ass Buster Sword and he's named Cloud and he's emo all the time. You know, I mean, we don't want characters like that. I mean, ideally, they should be like sort of same, like plausible characters, but at the same time, awesome. And there's like something funny about them, maybe like, you know, that kind of thing. So yeah, so you guys who are watching the stream, you have extra time to prepare. We'll probably yeah, that is actually a nice oh man, yeah, these NPC ideas are pretty funny. You know, with the modding capabilities, you guys can actually like put these NPCs in anyway, you know, like just an FYI. So yeah, that's kind of, actually, if you have something to talk about these characters and like what sort of style you would want, because you'll end up, you know, writing these characters and such. So yeah. I'm not sure if Ratskan's still here. Ratskan, are you here?
Really, I think the art that we've been producing has been more or less representative of what I've imagined the characters as.
No. I mean, for the contest, like, do you have any guidelines for the backers? Like, okay, don't do this, don't that kind of thing.
Okay, so basically, I'm just 600,000 years behind the live stream. Oh, do I have any guidelines for the backers? I see. Well, hang on a second, let me mute the audio again so I don't drive myself insane. Yes. So, as far as guidelines for the characters goes, I would actually probably be most comfortable working with those people a little bit, like, you know, obviously they need to fit within... I think it really, as long as you take the general perspective of, if I'm creating, like, an NPC for a D&D game, and I make, you know, some concessions to the fact that this happens in a city with this tech level, you know, you should be able to, looking at the screenshot, get a pretty good idea of where they're at. And, you know, this, if you look at even just the information we provide about the city and the backer updates, then I think you should have a great idea of what the character will be like. As far as, you know, any specific details goes, I would just negotiate anything that didn't seem fair, but I'll try to implement as best as possible what's ever given to me. If I'm given something with a lot of blank spaces, then I will fill it in with something interesting. And I will try to work with the person to, you know, make sure that that's okay with them, because, you know, this is something they paid money for. And end transmission.
So yeah, that was what, yeah. So yeah, I mean, yeah, you know, I mean, they're not like anything like too complex or stuff like those guidelines. But yeah, so ultimately, yeah, this won't be a kind of lucky draw, I guess. I mean, though, I mean, I guess if like a lot of backers are like, okay, no, get this guy's NPC, this seems awesome, we'll take that into account. But yeah, so ultimately, yeah, like try it out, like. Yeah, I mean, try to get, it won't be like that, you know, like, we don't need a complete, like, compendium on a character and his backstory and stuff like that, you know. I mean, we can fill out the details ourselves. So yeah, that's a major announcement for our, like, awesome stream followers, which is that we have, the Naga book. Wait a minute, are we talking about Anna Physique here? Because yeah, because that was like, yeah. So all right, so I think yeah, we'll wrap it up then. Any last minute questions or any comments and such? Okay, you are welcome, and like, thanks for watching, and we'll see you later. Now I need to hunt for the end broadcast button. So yeah, okay, where's the end broadcast button? End broadcast, where the hell is this? Is it this big red stop button? I hope so. I'm going to click the stop button now.